Hi everyone, today I'm going to show you the way on how to open any browser or any program automatically when you turn on your computer. It means you can add any browser or program to the startup list of the windows to make them open automatically. Let's take example of Google Chrome in a program that should start automatically.
Muradi tutorial. Transforming experience, presenting opportunities.
Method number one, how to add any app or program on the startup using --startup command. Before we are gonna make Google Chrome start automatically and put it on the startup list. So first of all, we have to check our startup list. If we have the Google Chrome, by going to right click on the taskbar and choose task manager. Open the startup tab. If you see here, I do not have any Google Chrome. So how to bring the Google Chrome here and start the Google Chrome automatically when the Windows starts? All you have to do is go to start search and type Chrome. If you see on the right hand side, there are some information or tasks that you can do with the Google Chrome. Like uninstall, pin to taskbar, pin to install, like this. You have to choose open location. When you open location, you see here Google Chrome icon. Right click on Google Chrome icon and copy it. Close this. Go to start search. Type run. Enter. On run window, write down shell. --startup. Enter. This is the folder where we copy the shortcut of any program or any browser, and that program and browser will start automatically along with Windows. Right click and paste. Now if we go to task manager, you see Google Chrome has been added. Let me show you side by side. If I delete this from here, on task manager, on a startup list, the Google Chrome will disappear. You see, when I paste it, it comes again. When you have any program or any browser on this startup list of the task manager, then you can enable or disable it. It is automatically enabled. From here, you can disable it. But we keep it because we want Google Chrome to open automatically. Now let's restart our computer and see if the Google Chrome opens automatically. Here computer is restarting. Look at Google Chrome. Google Chrome opened automatically. Now let's do it with any program. For example, I want to open TeamViewer automatically. I go to start search and type TeamViewer. Click on open location. If you see, this is the shortcut of the TeamViewer. Either you right click and copy it, or if you have the shortcut on your desktop, you can copy this shortcut from here and go to start search, type run, then type --startup, click on OK, paste it here. Let's go to task manager and see if it is there. You see, TeamViewer also came here. Now let's restart our computer and check it if it is working. Here computer is restarting. Computer started. You see Google Chrome also started automatically. Let's wait for TeamViewer. Here you go, TeamViewer also started automatically. Now, if you want to disable it, you can go to Task Manager, open Startup tab, Chrome, disable from here, and also the Team Viewer, disable. It was method number one. Let me show you another method, how to add any app or program on the startup without using shell colon startup command. It is very easy. We do method number two because it is a little fast. We do not need to go to start search and type run and write shell colon startup on the run window. So how we do it? For example, if you want to open any program or any app automatically when the Windows starts, simply you go to start search and type that app or program name. For example, I write Word. This is the Word. On the right hand, you find the open option here. Here, when you expand it, there will be file location. Open the file location. Copy the shortcut of the app or program on the same folder. If you see there is a folder by the name of startup here, when you open this folder, you paste it here. It prompts you, you will need to provide administrator permission to apply to this folder. You just click on continue. Now if you go to task manager and we open a startup tab, you see there is MS Word visible there. If you want to delete it, let me show you side by side. You see the word will be gone from here. If I paste it again, click on continue, MS Word comes here. So whenever you want to disable it and you want it to be here, you just click on disable. If you want to remove it completely, you can right click on the shortcut from the folder and delete it. Simple. That's it guys. Good luck.